Station Houston on 2. Don, looks good from here. You go ahead and press play.
Okay, I'm going to hit play now. This one involves using these little speakers that I found that we have with our laptop computers. And they have that little grate on front. And I happened to find a set of speakers where that grate just fell off. Here are the little speakers. They're stereo speakers. And the little metal part, the metal cone of the speaker is 20 millimeters in diameter, and it's surrounded by a little flexible bellow so it can move in and out. And that's what makes it a speaker. And again, this is powered off the USB port on a computer, so it can make quite a bit of sound. Since I found this, I thought maybe there's something I could use this for. Wouldn't it be neat if I could take my MP3 player and run tones through these speakers, and then I could put a drop of water on here and see what happens to the drop of water without the complications of gravity. So let's see what's going to happen when we look at water with this. So here we have a 30 millimeter blob of water, hemisphere, sitting on this speaker, and I'm running some tones through it. And I'm sweeping the frequency from around 20 hertz to 30 hertz. So this is low frequency stuff. And look at these wild oscillations that you could drive into this hemisphere of water. And depending on the frequency and the amplitude, you can make anything from standing ridges to a whole series of lobes. Now here's a smaller drop of water, and it exhibits a series of oscillation modes, similar but different. It's really amazing to see this. And you can see this on a length scale that would be impossible to see on Earth because gravity would make this just flatten out. And you reach a point where we almost have this chaotic behavior here where not only does it squirt drops off at the apex, but it just starts to squirt drops off from all around the hemispherical surface. And here's that section played back five times slower than real. You can see the lobes growing up on the surface. It almost reminds me of some kind of a embryo stage of a sea creature trying to grow tentacles or something. And then those lobes start to grow out to the point where surface tension will neck off a free drop. And I am amazed at how much fun you can have with something as simple as just a little set of speakers from your laptop computer and a splash of water. Now here's another drop. This one's a little bit smaller, and here I'm starting off at 20 hertz, sweeping up towards 40, and this particular drop gets into these gross up and down oscillations and starts to eject droplets right at the apex. But a most amazing thing happens. It actually makes a cavity, and that cavity gets pinched off and it makes air bubbles inside. Now here's a smaller drop, and look at what this drop does. It is consistently squirting free droplets off at its apex.